We're now 3 full weeks into this frog experiment, and the larvae are showing no signs of stopping. The larvae still don't seem to be able to swallow the tube effects or the white worms, so I decide to pick up some water freeze or some Daphnia to see if those would work. But just like with the worms, they're attracted to them, but they just can't swallow them. I also try some white midges, which they do seem able to catch from time to time. But even if the midges are easier to catch, I notice that the larvae still have a tough time swallowing them whole. In the wild, there'd be so many different sized organisms the tadpoles could possibly eat. But in an aquarium, we just have to try different things, see if they work, and hope that they get enough food to eat. So far, so good, because they're growing fast. An empty, ghostly skin of a frog appears one day in the pond. But it isn't a dead frog. It's just the skin that an adult frog has shed. Frogs, just like all reptiles and amphibians, shed their skin, and normally they eat it because it's full of nutrients. For frogs who breathe through their skin, renewing it is a critical part of staying alive. I'm super excited on the 22nd day because again, there are new eggs. And I don't know if this is the same frog each time that's laying them, but it's almost every other day that there's a new batch. And when you look at them closely, they develop almost before your eyes. They get dark within a few hours, and then only after about 15 hours, they're already in what's called the neural fold stage. This is when they move beyond just looking like a ball of cells to something with a dent in the top that'll eventually form the actual spinal cord. And a crazy thing is at the same stage of development, people look almost exactly the same. This is really something we share in common with all animals with backbones. We all kind of start the same way. What changes, though, is how we develop. And speaking of developing, the larvae are getting bigger and bigger, eating every day, and changes are happening almost before my eyes. It seems like the rule of the game here is that if you can fit it in your mouth and you can chase it down, it's fair game. And while Geronimo has no problem with the midge larvae, the smaller ones still do. In this world, it's pretty much eat or be eaten. After just 22 days, the largest tadpole's feet and legs are almost fully developed. There's still no claws on the feet, and the arms are already well developed and show tiny little hands with fingers. I can't really count them because there's too many, but at least 30 or 40 larvae have survived to this point, so I transfer them out of the main pond and into the aquarium I set up a few days ago. I still keep the tadpoles in a floating dish because it both protects them from the current and makes it easier to feed them. I cycle the water several times a day just to keep it fresh, but at least this means I've got all the tadpoles in one container where I can keep an eye on them and get them fed. That was a mistake. Even though all the tadpoles are active, swimming, and feeding, 10 of them simply disappear overnight. It appears that the 8-day-old tadpoles are just no match for the 22-day-old ones. I knew they had the potential to be cannibalistic, but this really surprised me. There's just no compassion among amphibians. Another lesson learned. There's nothing to do but protect the remaining ones and keep in mind, it's always survival of the biggest. The next morning, though, it's back to the nursery, because batch 7 is just about ready to hatch. And the surviving larvae from batch 6 are eating great. And even though they show no signs of stopping to gorge on the Artemia nauplii, I try to give them a range of foods. For living food so far, I've tried brine shrimp, white worms, white midges, tube effects, and water fleas. Of course, I'm also trying a range of dry foods as well. I'm learning as I go, and things aren't done yet, so I'll make a summary at the end. Unfortunately, tragedy strikes again, because one of the adults gets sucked into the filter intake in the main pond. I do everything I can to try to nurse the frog back to health, but it starts developing a secondary fungal infection. After a couple of days, the frog just doesn't accept food anymore. It's very clear I need to put it to sleep. To prevent this from happening in the future, I first cover the drain intake with the coarse sponge that I got with my sponge filter. Then I protect it with something a little more permanent. It's day 24, and Geronimo is the undisputed king of the tadpoles. He's always trying to find something new to eat, always on the prowl. The white worms are particularly appealing. They're just not terribly cooperative. Finally, one goes down the hatch. It seems the Artemia and nauplii are a little easier to catch. And so it goes. Over 3 weeks into this project, and the tadpoles are bigger than ever. I never even expected the first larva to survive, but now I've got a full frog nursery. And more on the way.